Welcome to the Code Kit. We're about to learn how to build circuits, create code, and make awesome games and inventions with littleBits. We'll walk you through building this invention to show you everything you need to get started. First, we need to learn how littleBits works, so let's explore some bit basics by building a circuit together. Every circuit needs a source of power, so let's start by getting power from our battery to our bits. Once you connect your battery to your power bit, the light on the power bit should turn red. If the power bit doesn't light up, its battery is out of power. Your battery needs to be recharged, but that can wait until later. For now, plug your USB cable into your computer or the wall adapter instead of the battery. Next, grab a bar graph bit and snap it to your power bit. All bits snap together with magnets. If your bits don't easily snap together, one of your bits is probably backwards or upside down. Just flip one of the bits around and they should connect. Try adding the button between your power and bar graph. Do you see what happens when you press the button? You'll notice there are a few different colors of bits. That's because they're color-coded to tell you what they do. Blue bits are power bits. They connect your circuits to a power source and send the signal that runs through your circuit. Green bits are outputs. They take the signal and use it to do stuff, like light up, make noise, or move. The pink bits are inputs. They control the signal coming from the power. They take that signal and tell the output bits that come after them what to do. Think of orange bits as wires. They connect bits together in different ways. Now that we've got some bit basics down, let's learn how to add code to our inventions. To do that, we're going to need to add a super powerful bit. The code bit! The code bit is a tiny computer that connects to the littleBits Code Kit app on your computer. You can tell the code bit what to do by creating code and uploading it to your bit wirelessly. Think of it like a brain for your littleBits circuits. Your brain can read signals from your inputs like your eyes, nose, and mouth. We call these our senses. Your code bit reads the signals that other bits send through its input bit snaps. These are labeled N1, N2, and N3 on your code bit. Your brain sends signals through its outputs, making sounds with your vocal cords and movement with your muscles. If we were like fireflies, we'd have light outputs too. Your code bit sends its signals to other bits through its output bit snaps. These are labeled OUT1, OUT2, and OUT3. OUT1 has a special ability. It can send text and images to your matrix. OUT2 and OUT3 also have special abilities. They can send sound to your speaker. And like your brain, the code bit can do way more than just send and receive signals. Its real magic is in its ability to think, to compute, to follow instructions, and if you ask it to do something completely random. What it thinks and what rules it follows are up to you. You tell it what to do with code. So let's build something with the code bit and learn how to use it. There's a very important tradition in coding called Hello World, and you and your bits are about to become part of it. For years and years and years, whenever somebody has learned to code, the first program they make says, "Hello World." So naturally, we're going to teach our circuit to say, "Hello World," first with words, and then with a picture. Let's build your circuit so you can learn how to use it. Connect your battery to your USB power bit with a USB cable. Now snap the button to your power. Let's snap the power and the button into N2 on the code bit. Now let's grab a new output bit, the LED matrix. The LED matrix needs to be in something called serial mode. So make sure that the little switch on the board is set to serial. This mode is what lets the matrix read special signals from the code bit that tells it how to show images, animations, words, and numbers. Let's add the LED matrix to our circuit. Snap your LED matrix to OUT1 on the code bit. OUT1 is the only output with the special serial ability. Side note, if someone using this codeBit before you has already loaded code onto the codeBit, you might see stuff displayed on your matrix. Once you put code onto the codeBit, it stays there until you upload something new to it, even if you disconnect the power or walk away from your computer. This means that you can create an invention and the code will go anywhere your circuit goes. Before we start coding, you will need to plug the codeBit dongle into a USB port on your computer. Your computer uses this dongle to wirelessly send your code to your codeBit. We've got our circuit, so now it's time to code. After you close this video, follow the instructions on the sidebar to learn how to build, load, and customize code.